Good afternoon, Aaron. That filing made in a New York courtroom said that FairPoint carried about $2.7 billion in debt. And despite all this, FairPoint says they are going to move forward with some of their initiatives to expand and improve their networks. This is a company that has run into many financial problems over the last few months, even over the last year since it took over landlines and broadband services in northern New England from Verizon. The big thing FairPoint is emphasizing this afternoon is that customers will still get their services and their bills just like they always have. But the question now is, what impact do the changes have on the people who work for FairPoint? The CEO says the company is continuing direct talks with some of its unions. He said that the talks are about what to do about how the company pays the workers in the future. But he said that right now there are no discussions about dropping people's pay. He did say that as the company moves forward, it will continue to look at cost cutting and that there's a possibility for layoffs, but it's not clear who those layoffs may affect.
A lot of people were saying that you were already in over your heads, that the Public Utilities Commission of New Hampshire and some of these northern New England states shouldn't have approved the expansion. Do you feel in any way that you made a mistake, or do you have regrets about taking over a system that some people say you just couldn't handle?
I think it's fairly irrelevant what should have happened or could have happened in the past. So I'm very focused on making this a very viable system, a very viable company, for northern New England and the rest of the states we serve going forward.
So here's some interesting statistics. FairPoint's stock price has really taken a beating since they took over on February 26, 2008, down about $10 since that takeover from Verizon. Now the governor is saying, and the state is saying, that they are going to work with FairPoint through this bankruptcy proceeding. Of course, we're going to have more on this story tonight on News 9. Live in the newsroom, Aaron Kellogg, WMUR News 9.